Hello there, Randall Schwartz here, back again with another tip or trick or technique about Dart and or Flutter, and maybe both. Here we go. In a previous episode, which I will link in the show notes, I talked about using the Dart 3 pattern matching to identify an async snapshot from a stream builder to select which widget to display based on the state. If the snapshot had data, we turned it into a text widget. If there is an error, we rethrow it. Otherwise, we show our old friend, the circular progress indicator. I constructed a simple stream counting from 0 to 9 at 1-second intervals, preceded by 5 seconds before the first count. This variable is initialized directly in the declaration of the state variables. I used an immediately executing closure, a technique I learned from back in my Perl days. But although the pattern match here reduces some of the boilerplate, it wasn't as elegant as the async value from RiverPod and its when method. I could simply append when and give 3 closures for data, error, and loading. I wondered if it would be possible to have something a bit more like this, just attach a when onto the async snapshot and provide data, error, and loading callbacks. Well, I worked a bit on an extension to async snapshot, and this is actually working code. Let's look at how the extension is implemented. I created an extension using a T generic for the type of snapshot. For this example, T would be int. I added a second generic R representing the return value, which would nearly always be widget. But I wanted to make this generically generic in case I had other uses for an async snapshot when. Then I identified the 3 different callbacks, giving their proper function signature. I lifted the pattern match from the previous code and inserted it here, using it to call one of the 3 callbacks. Pretty simple. I then thought I almost always want to throw an unexpected error and have a circular progress indicator. Those should be the default. But I couldn't make them the default here because it would ruin my common R type. So I wrote an extension to an extension. I added a whenWidget method to async snapshot. In this case, I no longer needed the R generic type, because I was going to deal only with widget returns. I removed the required and made the arguments nullable types, so that I could have defaults. This method calls the previously described when method, passing the arguments along if they are present. If they are absent, the incoming parameter will be null, and I substitute exactly what I had before, figuring that those were the most likely default choices. And given that all 3 of these defaults are what I had originally, I didn't have to provide anything at the invocation now. This program produces identical output at each change I've shown. I made one final change to move the extensions into their own file, and created a Git repo with each step so you can see for yourself. I've put a link in the show notes. As always, if you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe and tell your friends, and join my Patreon or buy me a coffee if you choose.